Hello everyone, this is Mr. Brain Junkie here, and today we'll be talking about a romantic fantasy film called White Snake. Be ready for some spoilers ahead. Somewhere far away in the outskirts of ancient China, numerous demon hunters are trying to hunt down the legendary snake demon inside the ghostly fogs. A beautiful woman in red dress begins running out from the mist, almost like she's trying to escape from something dangerous. A demon hunter rushes forwards and grabs onto the damsel in distress, but she immediately begins flirting with her savior, trying to get him to pay for her child support. The man becomes frightened by the proposal and throws the woman away immediately, realizing that she's a terrifying demon. The warriors begin attacking her furiously by using their magic, but their efforts are useless as the demon covers them inside a giant red cloth. The monster manages to confuse the hunters and kills one of them amidst the chaos, but the leader quickly uses their sealing technique and traps the demon inside a floating door. While barely being able to hold off the enemy, the police officers arrive to help the demon hunters, but are quickly blown to pieces as the monster breaks free and reveals her true form as a giant centipede. Just before the demon is about to kill the police captain, a giant staff launches at the creature and pierces right through the demon's chest, revealing a legendary demon hunter called Manhai, who's here to slay the vicious beast alongside his pupil Gao. However, they quickly sense another aura escaping this area and realizes that the centipede monster was only a distraction. The enemy laughs at their futile efforts to hunt down the snake demon, accusing them of trying to steal her spiritual energy, but Manhai silences the monster right away by sealing her inside his demon container. The man is furious that he's tricked by the demon and quickly goes after the white snake. It turns out that the leader of the demon hunters known as Khan is responsible for the snake demon's manhunt, as the spiritual energy can grant him enormous power. On the other side, a woman called Bai struggles greatly while hearing a voice from heaven, telling her that she must experience the emotions of mortals before she can become a deity. She falls down from the stress of hearing from the gods and turns back into her true form, revealing that she is the legendary white snake. A young scholar of medicine called Xian eventually finds the snake on his journey and tries to care for the creature by keeping it warm, but soon sees another woman appearing in front of him with no legs and quickly faints onto the ground. It turns out that the girl's name is Qing and the younger sister of the white snake, who wants to kill the man thinking that he's a demon hunter. Bai stops the girl immediately, telling her that not all humans are evil and causing the sister to storm out in anger. Xian eventually wakes up and sees the white snake in her human form, making the man immediately fall in love as he stumbles awkwardly away from the woman. He thanks the girl for saving his life and eventually learns her name, causing the man to be filled by infatuation as he nearly forgets his way home. After seeing that Xian has left, Bai explains the message from the gods to her sister and tells the girl that she must find out its meaning by interacting with humanity. Qing warns the woman about how dangerous the mission is as the hunters are searching the entire city, but the demon shows her sister the legs that she obtained from 900 years of spiritual training, allowing her to blend in like a normal human. The woman flies towards the cave's entrance while Qing looks at her with envy, wondering how it feels to walk like a human being. The next morning, citizens of the town begin to gather for a meeting as they see numerous victims with hearts ripped out from their bodies. The soldiers offer everyone money for slaying any monsters that they encounter, as Bai watches from a distance, realizing the danger that she's in. At the same time, Xian is having a drink with the police captain, but their conversation is quickly interrupted when the man sees something from afar and rushes away immediately. Xian looks aimlessly while crossing a bridge that's filled with people, and he suddenly runs into the woman that he was looking for this whole time. They stare lovingly at each other in silence before Bai finally breaks the awkwardness by telling Xian that she was looking for him, as he left his umbrella the last time they met. The rain begins to conveniently pour down on the lovebirds, allowing Xian to offer the woman shelter as Bai smiles lovingly at the man. He takes the woman back to his school of medicine, where they're immediately greeted by one of his fellow classmates, telling Xian that his best friend's father is gravely ill. The man rushes inside quickly and sees the patient lying on the bed, but no matter what he does, he cannot return the person back to consciousness. Luckily, Bai is able to secretly aid him through the operation, allowing Xian to resurrect the victim almost immediately. His best friend Gao sees this and rushes to help the father right away, while Xian leaves in confusion, not sure exactly about what he did that saved his patient. Gao comes out soon after to stop Xian from leaving so that he can thank the man properly, and offers them to have dinner as a token of gratitude. At night, the two enters into the household and greets the man upon entrance, but soon realizes that the demon hunter Manhai is here as well, since he is the master of Gao. Bai quickly realizes that she's in terrible danger, but is forced to sit down at the dinner table as to not cause any suspicion. They all drink to celebrate the recovery of Gao's father, but the woman soon feels that something is wrong as her human form begins to regress into a snake. Manhai reveals that the alcohol they consume has a special ingredient that is made to weaken demons, so that the monsters will show their true form upon consumption. He accuses Bai to be a powerful snake demon, as he felt her demonic presence ever since she entered the town. Xian is furious at the man's claims and tries to defend his friend, but Manhai tells the woman to drink another round in order to prove her innocence. Just when Bai is about to consume the alcohol, her cup is destroyed by a flying dagger, which turns out to belong to her sister Qing. The demon is able to dispose the guards easily and sends them flying towards the ground, while Manhai rushes out in fury and chases after her immediately, giving Bai the chance to escape. The green snake tries to run desperately away from the hunter, but is quickly struck down by the man, who laughs at her useless attempts to escape. However, Qin begins laughing hysterically as Manhai feels another aura escaping from here, realizing that he's been tricked once again to pursue the wrong target, and immediately begins chasing after the white snake. On the other side, the minions of the demon hunter lord is returning to their master with bags of human heart, revealing that they are responsible for the recent murders. Bai is able to intercept them on their way and demands to know why the hunters are killing people instead of protecting them like they're supposed to. Her interrogation is quickly interrupted when Xian arrives alongside Manhai, allowing the hunters to escape from the woman's grasp. Despite finding out that the demon hunters are the true killers, Manhai is still determined to capture the white snake, believing that all demons are evil. Luckily, the conflict is eventually stopped by Shen, which ultimately allows Bai to escape, while Manhai shouts in anger that he'll capture her no matter the cost. The next day, when Shen returns home to his grandmother, the man is surprised to find that Bai is here as well alongside the woman. What's even more astonishing is that the demon has cured the old woman from blindness, allowing her to finally see her grandson once more. Shen decides to thank the woman by showing her the beauty around his village and seeing the cherry blossoms along the way. The man eventually brings her to his favorite location that's overlooking the lake, as the two begins to confess their true feelings for each other. Shen tells Bai that he'll always care for her no matter what happens, and wait for her in this location if they ever become separated. However, the romance is quickly interrupted when two villagers rush in on the couple, trying to warn Shen that the woman is a terrifying demon. The hunters arrive as well after receiving the intels from the villagers, and a fierce battle commences while the two parties clash into each other. Bai is able to gain the upper hand very easily and grabs onto one of the enemies, but Shen shouts for her to stop killing, giving the hunter a chance to stab the woman right in the stomach. The man rushes in to try and protect his friend, but is quickly proven to be no match for the opponents, while Bai tries to fight the rest of the enemies despite her wounds. Very soon, Shen gets overpowered by the hunter's leader, but the woman is able to save him from being killed, allowing herself to be stabbed by her enemies once more. Bai screams in agony, causing her to transform into a giant serpent that roars furiously at the demon hunters, blowing everyone away with her immense aura. Shen is knocked off the cliff as a result, but the demon quickly rushes towards her friend and is able to catch him in the last moment. When the man eventually wakes up, he realizes that he's lying on top of a giant snake and becomes frightened by the woman's true form as the demon approaches him closer. The massive serpent turns back into a human once again, and Shen quickly realizes that his friend is severely wounded from the fight. The man takes the woman onto his shoulders and begins running away from the area, eventually arriving towards the lake as the morning finally approaches. Luckily, Shen is able to find a fisherman who allows them onto his boat, and they continue to travel on the water as Bai slowly regains her consciousness. However, the woman soon sees a familiar face outside the boat, who turns out to be her sister Qing, but the demon attacks the scholar right away, blaming him for Bai's current predicament. Their arguments are quickly interrupted when the fisherman reveals himself to be Manhai, who's tricked the sisters into the opening so that he can finally confront the demons. The hunter tells Bai that it's forbidden for a demon to love a human, and their relationship would greatly offend the heavens, but the white snake doesn't care about becoming a deity anymore, as long as she can be with the person that she loves. Bai attacks the demon hunter alongside his sister, and the three begin to battle furiously as they exchange blows on the water. The demons chase Manhai onto the boat, but the man unleashes a powerful shockwave that knocks the sisters flying backwards and pinning them onto the walls. Seeing that his lover is hurt, Shen tells the demon hunter that he'll end his relationship with Bai as long as the man promises to spare their lives. Manhai reluctantly agrees and takes the main character away, while the woman cries in despair as she sees her lover disappear forever. Sometimes later, Shen has decided to move on and focus his energy on studying medicine, but the demon hunters quickly rush into the man's location, demanding to know the whereabouts of the snake demon and threatening to kill everyone who's here. Shen refuses to cooperate and betray his lover, causing the enemies to attack the scholars furiously, killing many of the people as a result. While fighting amidst the chaos, Gao grabs onto Shen and brings him upstairs, trying to escape from the enemy's massacre. The main character tells his friend to warn the white snake about the demon hunters and reveals their location to Gao as he has made a promise towards Manhai to never see his lover again. Shen watches Gao escape from the area and prepares to defend against the enemies all by himself, but the man quickly gets thrown out from the buildings and lands right in front of the police officers. The men do not dare to arrest the demon hunters, but manages to save Shen's life as the killers laugh maniacally while walking away from the victims. However, it's soon revealed that Gao was working alongside the enemies the whole time, as he wishes to be known as the hero who captured the snake demons for his people. The demon hunters are able to locate the sisters very quickly and begins attacking the demons with all their armies. Gao rushes in towards the white snake and raises the umbrella that belongs to Shen, claiming to have a message for the woman that belongs to her lover. Bai runs towards the traitor without thinking and immediately gets stabbed in the stomach while Cheng knocks the man away and tries to save her sister. The green snake sees her only family gravely wounded and charges at the humans in fury, slashing the man into pieces as she tries to take vengeance for her sister. Very soon, Shen arrives towards the battlefield and quickly holds on to his lover who's bleeding on the floor. The man apologizes for not being here for her and blames himself for trusting the wrong person. Shen tries to help his lover escape from the demon hunters, but gets repeatedly stabbed by the enemies as he tries to defend the woman. Realizing that they have no chance to run away together, Bai decides to transfer her spiritual energy to Shen so that at least the man can survive. The white snake pushes her lover away from the battlefield, causing Shen to helplessly scream out her name as the two sisters are finally captured by the enemies. Upon entering the demon hunter's lair, Cheng immediately senses a strong presence of demonic aura, suspecting that the enemy's leader Khan is actually a demon in disguise. The man flies towards the sisters and is furious that Bai has given her spiritual energy away. He demands that Cheng retrieve the scholar for him by threatening to torture the white snake right in front of her. With no other choice, the green snake decides to go after Shen as Bai cries hopelessly while watching her sister leave. Cheng arrives at the location where the man has promised to wait for her sister, but instead of capturing him, the demon tells the scholar to run as far as he can. However, upon hearing that Bai is still alive, Shen decides to fight against the demon hunters alongside Cheng, even if the odds are stacked against them. The two arrive to the entrance of the cave and are quickly confronted by numerous hunters, but a golden aura pushes the enemies aside. It turns out that Manhai has arrived to confront the evil lord himself after sensing Khan's energy and realizing that he may be a demon as well. They make it into the caves and Shen immediately rushes towards the white snake, freeing her from the chains and giving her back the spiritual energy, eventually fainting from the stress of losing all his powers. The green snake tries to fight the enemy all by herself, but quickly gets overpowered by the man and knocked towards the ground. But Manhai is able to save her in the last moment and reveals to everyone that Khan is actually a demon in disguise. Manhai attacks the demon lord alongside Cheng, but even their combined efforts are not enough to challenge Khan as the enemy knocks them around and pins them towards the ground with little effort. Meanwhile, Bai finally regains her consciousness, only to see that Shen is in critical condition after trying to save her. The woman screams in agony and transforms into a giant serpent while rushing towards the demon lord, trying to take vengeance on the man for harming the person that she loves. The two levitates into the air and Khan begins releasing all his power towards the white snake, trapping her inside his aura of energy. Bai tries attacking the demon lord, but her powers are quickly proven to be inferior as she's continuously hit by the dark energies. Seeing that they're losing the battle, Manhai transfers a part of his aura into Shen, managing to finally force the man into consciousness. As the fight progresses, Khan is able to slowly bring out the spiritual essence from the white snake and begins consuming it into himself. However, Shen quickly appears behind the demon and sacrifices himself while stabbing through the enemy, finally turning the evil creature into dust and falling down onto the ground. The snake demon holds onto her lover as the man takes the last breath, promising to find her in the next life, while the woman smiles with tears in her eyes. 100 years later, the White Snake is now a deity after experiencing the many emotions of mortals. She goes alongside her sister to the town where she first met Xian and tries to remember the feelings of love and joy that she experienced. What she doesn't realize is that the reincarnation of Xian is crossing the bridge just like many years ago, and the man begins to notice someone familiar from afar, seemingly remembering his lover from the previous life. So what do you guys think about this movie? Let me know in the comments below. And if you like my video, please press like and subscribe for more. I'll see you guys next time.